this is Bradford, and he's the dresser. So I guess it's appropriate that he is in this little film, since we probably won't bring him on stage on Sunday night, although maybe we will.
You know, really, I'm not as impressed by the act of putting up the show as I thought I would be. You know, I mean, I'd only seen him in Wigstock, and I thought it was really great. I thought there would be more, though, to, you know, the actual performance. But really, I think, you know, I think he's actually mentally retarded.
Woo!
And this is Lewis, and he's the makeup artist.
Lewis!
The makeup's got to be aesthetic and youth-enhancing, but and it's definitely necessary for both. You know, after the fishing line takes its toll and the tapes, as long as there's lots and lots and lots of lighting. Lots of lighting. Did I mention lighting?
I rely on the technical complexity, and when it goes wrong, it's a little unnerving because my performance relies on it so much, because the sound is the sound, you know, and that's what I'm performing to.
Lypsinka is nothing but a dry queen with a cassette tape.
Hey, I'm Gregory. I'm the sound person, and I've never seen anyone who's like really doesn't care about their show. Basically, he comes on with food in his mouth. Sometimes he'll come on completely in street clothes. There have been times where I've accidentally put in a wrong cassette or CD, and he doesn't seem to notice. The audience doesn't seem to notice.
I can't go on with the scene, not too happy.
Well, actually, the show's not that difficult to do. Everyone's so amazed at how good John is. But in fact, you know, if people knew how easy it was. Once when we were in the middle of the run, John got sick, and we just couldn't afford to stop because, you know, we'd spent so much money on the show. So we decided, well, we have to keep going. We got a chimpanzee who did the show for about 5 performances, and it was amazing. He was really, really good.
I thought the monkey was a lot graceful, and it looked more like it was lip singing than lip sync. It was a lot funny, really funny watching the monkey move around instead of lip sync moving with her hands sliding around the place. The monkey had a tail that would wiggle around. It was just a lot more entertaining watching a monkey doing it than a person trying to look like a woman. I don't know, what do you think?
I think, yeah, and the monkey, it's not very picky either.
You know, one time at the end of August, I asked him where a line came from, and he offered to take me back to his house to show me some movies. You know, and I, frankly, you know, I'm a little uncomfortable with that, but he's offered once or twice a week since then, you know, to show me some movies. I think it's a euphemism for something else. And frankly, nobody even really knows where John lives. Kevin doesn't even know where John lives.
Well, I know he has a storage space, but I don't think he could possibly live there. He's... when I've gone on trips with him, we've picked him up in a car, but it's always been from, you know, like in front of a Dunkin' Donuts or something, standing out in front of the Dunkin' Donuts with his suitcases.
Not over here.
Drag queen cassette tape. Drag queen cassette tape. Really?
Keep watching. And
anybody could just go and sing along with a tape, right? I mean, it doesn't require any real talent.
Why don't you die?
And actually, you know, Kevin has already approached me about taking over for John. He said that John is just being a little problematic, and apparently his timing's off, and then there's this tour thing, and they don't know that John's going to be able to handle it, so I might actually be Lypsinka in San Francisco and in London.
Look at me!
Yeah.
funniest moment certainly was when Stephen Sondheim stood right there and he said, "To be vulgar, this show is fucking dazzling. You make me joyful. You make me want to go out and do something joyful."
Oh, God, the night Stephen Sondheim was here was great. He'd come to see Billy Connolly, I think it was performing upstairs, and Stephen had come downstairs and was looking for Billy Connolly because he wanted to go backstage and congratulate him on what a great show he did. And someone inadvertently sent him into John's dressing room, and John was, you know, really flabbergasted that Stephen had come to see his show.
I think he's actually mentally retarded.
I'm Carol Channing, and now I'm over here. I'm 80.
Mattresses.
Now I'm over here.
Oh, Gladiator!
Now I'm over here.
Bye, y'all! Bye, y'all! Bye, y'all!